This one doesn't have a title either. Roast potatoes and ISIS. Garden peas and crisis. It's a twisted form of Gogglebox. We all agree it's bad, but we nod politely. But the custard's really lovely. And it's on the other side of the world, so it's got nothing to do with me. What's for pudding? Is it ice cream? Yum, 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 Brexit fucked our country. Mum calls for us and she says, dinner's ready. Back in the time when our heads were less heavy and I'm 11 years old, uniform on, tucked in, napkin to my chin, and Mum tucks at the way that the world is spinning and says we can't begin to imagine what it's like to be at war. But we couldn't concern ourselves too much because our brains are too small. Polite knives and forks placed at 6:30 on the TV, the Iraq war confused at who exactly caused it, and I tried to understand it. And I tried to comprehend it. But it all goes out when I ask for more roast potatoes and garden peas. And even at 21, I still don't understand a foreign land. Because I've been brought up to sit and watch and watch and eat. My brain gets numb, but I'll still feast because someone else can bother and try and fix the Far East. It's on the other side of the world, so it's got nothing to do with me. Yum, 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 because I'll just turn off the TV. And it's only now that I'm changing my mentality, sat down eating dinner with my family. My mum says that the dinner table is not the place for debates, so I guess that my mad conspiracy theories will just have to wait. And whenever something on the news is mentioned, and I try to think of those awkward questions, across the table, my mum, dad and sister, I call it question time. My mum has another saying for this. She says, I'm ruining dinner time. Thank you.